Since the Tesla Autopilot hit the market, drivers have posted videos doing all sorts of things, except actually driving. Why not play games, eat snacks, even take a nap when the car can drive itself?
Oh my gosh.
In 2018, Inside Edition's Jim Moray got in a Tesla with someone who drove with no hands on the wheel.
Okay, so autopilot's engaged.
Joseph Morad loves the autopilot feature of his Tesla.
What are you doing?
While taking Jim for a ride, he started reading and took a selfie with his phone.
Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. How you doing?
Morad says he drives with his feet hanging out the window. And that's what got him into trouble when a stunned California Highway Patrol officer pulled up alongside him.
He was blown away, did not know how to react to the incident.
What did he say to you first?
He asked me why I was driving with my feet out the window.
Of course, Morad was issued a ticket, but it had nothing to do with his feet. It was for going too slow, 25 in a 65 mile an hour zone. He says the car was going slow because of heavy traffic.
It wasn't for reckless driving. It was driving at an unsafe slow speed and talking on my phone.
The ticket was dismissed. Some Tesla owners don't even want to sit in the driver's seat.
I'm just chilling with my invisible chauffeur.
Tesla owner Rico Rosales doesn't bother to get behind the wheel. He's in the passenger seat.
By myself. It's going about 70 miles per hour.
In 2016, Rosales said he felt safe.
It does seem wildly dangerous, 70 miles an hour, and there's nobody behind the wheel.
That's a little dangerous, but you know, I have a lot of faith in their autopilot system. Despite it being in the beta stage, it was pretty safe and secure.
This guy has so much faith in Tesla's self-driving capabilities, he doesn't bother getting in the front seat at all.
Isn't this cool?
California Highway Patrol didn't think so. They arrested 25-year-old Param Sharma in 2021 for reckless driving. He spent a night in jail and his Tesla was impounded for a year, but he went right out and bought another.
If you're using it properly on roads that autopilot was designed to be used on, it is definitely not reckless. It is safe.
Sharma says he's been a backseat Tesla driver since 2018. Drawing attention to himself with social media posts of him staring at passing vehicles from the back seat of his driverless car. The dozens of crashes involving Teslas on autopilot that are under investigation don't faze him. Tesla's autopilot is not designed to operate without someone in the driver's seat. Sharma overrides the system by keeping the seat belt buckled and the door closed when he climbs out of the seat.
If you just take the belt off and you put the belt back on without it on your body, it actually tricks the autopilot into thinking there's a human there.
Whoa, that's a breeze. You didn't even notice, dude. What a
Sharma almost got caught again by San Francisco police during our interview.
Oh, dude, the police is yonder.
He climbs back into the driver's seat, you know, where he should have been all along.
I just think you guys can't understand me, man.
Some drivers don't bother staying awake.
If there's a black Tesla and the driver's sleeping.
A 911 caller reported that the driver of a Tesla was asleep as the car was traveling over 80 miles an hour.
I mean, he's not erratic, you know, the car stays safe. It's just that I looked over and he found asleep.
Dashcam video from Kenosha, Wisconsin police shows officers' attempts to get the driver's attention.
For about 2.2 miles, I had no reaction from the driver. Lights and sirens going, different pitches, different sounds from my audible, still no reaction.
Finally, the driver, named Mitu Patel, pulled over.
You were sleeping.
I was a little bit tired.
No, you were sleeping, sir. I was upside of you. I was looking at you and you were doing this. Your eyes were closed.
According to the Kenosha County Sheriff's Department, this isn't a first offense for this driver.
You have had two priors last year for the same thing. People called you in August and February of 2020. Where they observed you on the interstate sleeping.
Patel was not cited in those two incidents because he was awake when police caught up with him.
I was tired. I apologize.
You're telling me you were not sleeping.
I was tired.
Patel told WDJT that he had no on-camera comment. He denies that he was asleep and says the sheriff's story was inaccurate. Patel was cited for inattentive driving and his car was towed. Not everyone is so cavalier about self-driving vehicles. This grandmother back in 2016 wanted nothing to do with it.
Oh dear Jesus, I could never, oh, where's it going?
Shirley's son, Bill Rimmer, laughed as he videotaped his mom's reaction after he activated autopilot on his electric-powered Tesla.
Oh my God, oh, this is so scary. Oh Jesus, this is my first day out and I'm about to die.
Oh, come on, relax.
Safe to say this grandma won't be buying a Tesla anytime soon.
I could never,
Some people want a Tesla so badly, they're willing to fake it. This may look like the Tesla Cybertruck that's supposed to be released in late 2021, but it is not. Mario Koric says he's gotten lots of attention driving this down the streets of Bosnia in 2020. Since we know it's not a Tesla, what is he actually driving? A Ford F-150. It took 8 months for engineers at Stark Solutions to take the truck apart and make it look like Elon Musk's Cybertruck.
I want to try something different, so I present to you the Cybertruck.
Sharp edges on vehicles are banned in Bosnia, but even with the risk, some people will do anything to be seen in a Tesla. This is Inside Edition Digital.